Recently, a new study from the University of California, Berkeley has made a rumbling in the world of health and fitness. This study found that in mice, the element copper inhibits the effects of the enzyme PDE3. PDE3 itself inhibits the effects of a messenger molecule known as CAMP. CAMP is needed to activate the enzymes responsible for mobilizing fat cells. Think of it as copper being a crossing guard. It stops the PDE3 cars, allowing CAMP pedestrians to cross the road to the fat burning factory. You get the point. The main takeaway of this study, especially for science nerds, is that copper ultimately can be classified as a signaling element. It's long believed that the only signaling elements in the body were that of electrolytes, such as sodium, calcium, and potassium. Copper might, perhaps, be added to this prominent list. Now, before you go running off and buying copper supplements or food high in copper, do you know that you only need very small amounts to reach your daily intake? The recommended intake for the average adult is roughly 0.9 milligrams, which can easily be met by eating seafood, kale, mushrooms, beans, and nuts. Supplementation usually isn't necessary unless you have a high copper deficiency to begin with. And even if copper does play a role in fat metabolism, the process of fat burning is by and large still regulated by your hormones. Ask any other questions about health and fitness topics that you've recently heard about on the news. Thanks for watching.